So, you know that descriptive writing is used everywhere, right? Whether it's you telling a story or a menu. Well, now you also have some of the tools to write your own stuff very descriptively. You know that you can use the five senses. So, what you smell, what you see, what you hear, anything that you see or do in real life, you can translate that onto the page for your reader. You also know that it's a good idea to show, not tell when you can. Make sure that you're writing it almost as if it's a movie playing in your head. Remember that in a movie they wouldn't say George is sad, unless they're trying to be stylistic or something, they would show a shot of George crying. And also remember that one of your best friends when you are writing descriptively is the adjective. So also realize that there are some adjectives though that get overused. Big, small, nice, pretty. Be more general. Is someone graceful and elegant, or are they more cute? Is someone diminutive or minute, or are they, okay, I'm thinking of the fearsome chihuahua now, but you can also layer adjectives, like to go from the diminutive to chihuahua to the diminutive but fearsome chihuahua adds another dimension. So use adjectives, use the senses, show not tell, figurative language, metaphors, and similes give extra oomph to your writing. And never forget that you can really use descriptive writing on anything, whether it's princesses, Niagara Falls, or even a yummy looking sandwich. Try the activities, and remember that you can use so much material for descriptive writing, whether it's pictures off the web or your real life. Put descriptive writing to use wherever and whenever you want.